I have been asked to tell something about Indian railway station development, a story so far. Actually, if we remember, I think in 2006, this thought had processed in the Ministry of Railways. Some directorship was established there. They have gone for some modified bid challenge method, and they have selected some 24 stations. It was based on some Swiss challenge method, but I think response was not that good. Only two stations response was there. And finally, it was not accepted. Then again in 2012, in the budget speech, it was told that we should have a separate company for this. So based on that, I think the IRSDC has taken a berth. I will be speaking on regarding whole story. I will be covering in these aspects: improvement of passenger amenities by leveraging real estate. Station development is a big opportunity for the investors. Something about IRSDC, then status of projects being taken up by IRSDC. Then we have taken up one more vertical, that's integrated facility management on five stations as a pilot basis. I'll be telling that also what all we have done there. And then being a planning authority, we have developing our own control norms so that station development takes place in a holistic view. So these are, they will be my points. Station development, actually the main source of revenue is the real estate. Then till now, there were two sources of revenue only: the station estate development and some revenue from the station itself. Now the ministry has taken, gone further away, and the notification is like to be issued shortly that we'll be having some user charges also on the passengers. So there is some assured source of revenue for the station development, and the station development should now move very fast. So why the station development real estate can help is, actually we are having a great footfall on our stations. We are transporting almost equal to Australia on daily basis. The maximum footfall is 100 cities, almost 70% of footfall, and there is a growth also of traffic, 7% annual growth is there. There is a huge land available, 2,700 acres of land which can be given on 99 years, up to 99 years of lease, and there is almost 100 largest cities in India where this is possible. And the land is available encroachment free. This data has been prepared based on BCG report and submitted to railways. Presently, focus is on 400 stations. As I told, 2,700 acres of land is available. There is a potential of commercial development of around 68,000 crore rupees. And for station development itself, there is a potential of 28,000 crore rupees. So in total, if we say it's almost 1 lakh crore investment is required at these stations. We can, as approved by cabinet, union cabinet, we can go for any type of model for station development. We can go for PPP. We can unbundle the projects. We can go for EPC separate and commercial development separately. We can have a development partner on which we are working with our funding agencies also, not yet launched, but we have already developed some document, we have circulated to the funds, we are working on this also. And there is a modified bid challenge, Swiss challenge, modified slightly to Swiss challenge. On that also we are working, we are open to it, not yet launched, although ministry has tried, but we have tried to modify the document and working on this also, but still it's in conceptual stage only. And then another model is that we can do self-development also. We can, RSDC can do self-development itself. So we are planning to do it on Chanakpuri railway station. RSDC was established with a vision to be a leading organization in the field of development, redevelopment, operation and maintenance of railway stations with passenger amenities of international standards. So with that, this RSDC was established in 2012. It's a joint venture company of RLDA and IRCON. Till September 2017, it was a subsidiary of IRCON. But now I am happy to say that RITES is also coming on our board. So it will be a joint venture company of RLDA, IRCON, and RITES. It's a board-run company. ME, Member Engineering Railway Board, is our chairman. We have MD and CEO, Mr. S.K. Lohia. There are three functional directors. Presently, only one director is there. There are four promoter directors also on our board, two each from our promoters. And we have three government nominee directors, one each from Ministry of Railways, Niti Aayog and DA. With the approval of Cabinet on 3rd April 2018, IRSDC is the nodal agency as well as the main project development agency. And we can lease up to 99 years with commercial or residential. Where residential is there, it is up to 99 years. And where we are doing only commercial development, then up to 60 years we have been allowed to lease the land. Development permitted on different modes of such as PPC, PPP, EPC, self-development, etc. And IRSDC shall approve its own plans in consultation with local bodies, following the national TOD policy. And pan-India, we need no change of land use is required as per the Union Cabinet approval. So we'll be focusing, while developing stations, we'll be focusing of seven Cs. We have to have a congestion-free station with segregation of arrival and departure of passengers. Then we have to take care about the convenience of the passengers by providing lifts, escalators, etc. Then we have to conserve the natural and built environment at the station, like we are doing at Habibganj. We are holding the main station. At Nagpur, we are keeping the heritage of the station. We are not disturbing the main station, and development has been planned all along the heritage building. Then we have to have cleanliness in our mind. Then we have to have clear and fast communication system at the station. And we have to converse all the modes of the transport. So we have to have multimodal transport integration at our station. And overall, that we have to create a 24/7 city center, which is live all the time. This is a picture of Habibganj station. I told the two stations we are already working. Physical progress is there. Habibganj station will be completing by April or May this year itself. These are some of the pictures of November 2019. This is some 1 year, 1 month old picture. If you see the left side, we are doing the commercial development. In between is the old station, which has been kept intact. And right side, we are developing east and west buildings with the concourse. The two subways has already been made operational. We have already covered the platforms. There's another picture of, and we will be doing proper traffic circulation plan also. These are some of the pictures of Habibganj station when it is completed. It will look like this from inside. Another station which I told, that Gandhinagar, we are already developing a 318-room hotel, five-star hotel is being made right on the tracks. It is very near to Mahatma Mandir. It will be the first five-star hotel in Gandhinagar. So this is our dream, and presently we are at this point. It is almost 90% work has been done. And three more stations we have taken, as I told, that we can do. We have done unbundling also, EPC. We have done EPC tender for Anand Vihar, Bijwasan, and Chandigarh. So EPC tender for Anand Vihar has already been awarded. Work has started on the ground. Soil investigation and all that is being done. And for commercial development also, we have issued the RFP. For Chandigarh also, it has been accepted EPC mode on 30th October. Again, RFP has been issued. Bijwasan station, again, EPC has been accepted on 30th October, and RFP is issued. We are waiting for land entrustment for Anand Vihar and Bijwasan so that we can open the tenders. For Chandigarh, already land entrustment has come from railways. So we'll be shortly, I think by April, we should be able to award these contracts if bids come with our whatever we are planning that way. Salient features of four stations, has been approved by PPAC committee. These are Amritsar, Nagpur, Sabarmati and Gwalior, and we have issued RFQ for these stations. There is huge built-up area available at Amritsar, 6.5 lakh square feet. Nagpur, 20 lakh square feet built-up area is there, and Sabarmati, 18.5, and Gwalior, 9 lakh square feet area is there. If you see the indicative cost of this station, it will be 375 crores at Amritsar, Nagpur 465 crores, Sabarmati 156, and Gwalior 300 crores rupees. There is an augmentation also planned at three stations. Amritsar, it is being planned at the one stage itself. Augmentation will take after at around 20 years when the congestion is there at the station. So augmentation will be done by the developer. These are Nagpur station architectural plans. This is Gwalior station, what we are planning. We are maintaining the heritage of the station. The old station will be enveloped from outside, and look and feel of the station will be kept as it is. This is the Amritsar station. It will be covered fully because the present station is very old, and we are planning to rebuild like this. This is another picture of Amritsar station. So to fast track the station development, the Ministry of Railway, with the help of other ministries, has taken this step, that a group of secretaries has been constituted. Already seven meetings has taken place, and this is fast tracking. All the decisions are being taken in this meeting. We are planning this year itself, we have to the RFQ has to be issued for 50 stations. And 60 stations we are developing on our own. RLD is doing developing 50 stations, and for our 30 stations we have to plan RFQ by July 2020. As I already told, we have awarded on EPC mode three tenders, Anand Vihar, Bijwas and Chandigarh. RFQ called for four stations, and CSMT also we have issued, we have given for PPAC approval to the Ministry of Railways. Two stations we are Udhna and Surat, we are going to submit to PPAC station within 1 or 2 days. This is our Pan India presence, where all we are working. There are 45 stations, 61 stations, and I am happy to say that we have signed an MOU with 6 CPSEs. These are MECON, EPIL, RITES, IRCON, NPCC, and Bridge and Roof. Some 7 to 8 stations has been given to each and every CPSEs. They will be working as PMC to IRSDC. They are developing, they are preparing DPR of 45 stations. This is the strategy for calling further tenders. We have, the ministry has given targets to do RFQ of these stations. So 59 stations has been planned. Abu Road, of course, we have asked railways to give some more land because it's not coming to be viable presently. Further, to have a look and feel of the stations itself, because when the station is developed for 60 years, it will be with the developer, and RSDC will be looking after operation and maintenance and development of station itself, and recording and commercial development also. So we have taken five stations on for integrated facility management also. These are Bangalore, Pune, Secunderabad, Chandigarh and Anand Vihar stations. We have taken a lot of initiatives, we have concluded so many contracts, and I'm happy to say that in the last slide I will be covering that we are going to break even in this year itself on two stations, and by next year we'll break even at all the five stations. So there will be, that will be no cost to railways. We'll be working on from the earnings from the station itself, we'll be doing this. Importance features of station facility management, that we are doing professional facility management. We have deputed like UDS, Knight Frank and BBG for our these stations, and we are optimizing on the manpower details. Payment of minimum wages as per statutory provisions has been there. We are taking biometric attendance of housekeeping staff and MEP staff, and we are doing mechanized cleaning at these stations. Redevelopment of railway staff and consequent reduction in railway expenditure has been done at almost 25 to 30 staff of railways has been withdrawn at each of these stations. And we are doing quick award and execution of commercial tenders, exploring new and innovative ideas and quick implementation to increase passenger experience at these stations. So we have taken a lot of initiatives at these stations. We are, as I told, we are doing mechanized cleaning at these stations. And this is the picture of concourse at Anand Vihar station. If you see that, you can feel the difference at these stations. We have installed May I Help You desk at all our five stations. We are doing segregation of wet and dry waste at all these stations. We have done renovation of AC waiting halls. These pictures are from Anand Vihar, but we are doing all these stations like this. We have provided sanitary napkin vending machines and incinerator machines at our stations in our toilets. Plastic bottle crushing machines has been provided at all these stations. And we have put proper passengers for passengers, posters for the awareness of the passengers. Then this, you must have heard in the news, Fit India Squat machine has been installed at Anand Vihar, and we are going to shortly install the march itself at our Bangalore station. This picture was viral in the market. Actually, you can get a free platform ticket if you do 30 squats in 3 minutes. So it is to promote the Fit India movement of Government of India. And we are promoting startup companies also. There's a four boys who has put up a new shop with the name of New Shop at Anand Vihar station. Very innovative products they have brought, and it has picked up very well. Another good initiative we have taken, that it's a Meghdoot water kiosk we have installed at Secunderabad. It manufactures wire from the air moisture. It's very good, and it is very cheap also in comparison to the water available like Rail Neer and the RO system, whatever is being done by IRCTC. So it's very cheap. It's a novel idea to conserve water and ensure healthy and safe drinking water for passengers by introducing Meghdoot device at Secunderabad station. The device harvests water directly from air, which is then filtered and remineralized for drinking. The water complies with the World Health Organization standards. And one more initiative we have taken at Anand Vihar, although it will be doing other stations also, Dawa Dost, almost up to 80% cheap medicines are available at this station. It varies from 10% to 80%. It has home delivery also. It has been recently started, and we'll going to other stations also. So medicines are also available at our stations now. We are moving in all directions. This request came from Yoganand Satsang Society, so to install their book stall there, and it very unused space was available. So we have given them, and they have beautifully decorated this space. This also has been appreciated by the Parliament Amenities Committee, which has recently visited. We have provided quick food joints at our stations. Quality food is available. And then charging kiosk has been provided all these stations. In this, you can put your mobile in it and lock it and go for anywhere. And once per hour, I think they charge 10 rupees, so you can charge your mobile here. Then we have health machines we have installed, in which you can you can immediately check your BP and sugar within 5 minutes. So these machines have been installed at all our 5 stations. These are the AC waiting halls we are renovating at our stations. One ITC Sunfeast stall has been started at Bengaluru railway station. This has been also a quality product and been appreciated by all. Then nutritious and tasty food Nuti has been also installed at Bengaluru railway station. Platform tickets are being managed by us only. And for our disabled friendly, we have provided in Berle tactile map at Chandigarh station. We are planning to, this has been done in CSR activity. So we are open to CSR activities also, and a lot of people are coming and helping us. We are providing OYO and OLA kiosk route for to facilitate passengers to have immediate availability of transport, and for the taking care of health of the passengers, massage chairs has been installed. At Anand Vihar, Rigo Taxi has been, a booth has been opened. We are planning to have kids zone also at Anand Vihar, which will be shortly opened. Children, instead of roaming here and there, they can play here for some time and till they are waiting for their train. I am happy to say that Anand Vihar is the first station which has got 5-star rating for Eat Right station. We scored 92% there. This has been done by HUL. It's an initiative of Ministry of Railways. All our five stations are ISO 14001 certified. We have done energy and water audit also, and silver rating has been provided for Anand Vihar station. We are further exploring to provide pod hotels. We are talking someone at Bangalore. So shortly this will also be reality at our stations. At Anand Vihar, as he told, we have reduced almost 27 staff, railway staff, since we took over. So it is a saving of around 270 lakhs per year. As I told, we are doing commercial tenders also for our railway stations, and we have increased competition and we have increased revenue also. So Anand Vihar, if you see, for catering stalls, we got 24 bidders and number of bidders were 209. For Pune, we are winning number of bids 183. So we are increasing competition and we are getting good results also of that. So if you see the rentals per square feet, earlier it was around 10,000 per square feet. Now it has been doubled since we have taken over. It is around 21,000 per square feet. This is another comparison, and if you see the total income at our five stations, as I told you, when we took over, there was a huge gap of, they were all cash negative, there was a huge gap. Till end of March, we have bridged this gap slightly, but still there is some difference, and we are expecting that by 2021, we will be generating some surplus revenue from all these five stations without any cost to the railways. Further, as we are the planning authority, we have to approve our own plans ourselves in consultation with local authorities. We have to just consult and the railways also. So we are developed our own control rooms. Like for developers, we are giving just buildable volume. We are not specifying anything. We'll tell them that this is the plot available. You can build this much of volume on this plot, and he can plan anything like this. He can go any whatever way he wants to develop that commercial activities there. So we are developing form-based codes also. So for the station planning, we are doing. We have to develop the world-class station. We have to develop world-class railway facilities, and the station has to be self-sustainable. Regarding real estate, it has to work as 24/7 city center, commercially integrated with football. Then mixed-use development is permitted at all our stations. So that way we have planned our comprehensive planning we do at our stations. As I told, we have developed our control norms. We are experimenting with this in our Chandigarh railway station. We have already specified in our contracts these development control norms. These books will be released soon. So this was the whole story, how the station development is taking place and where all we have come till date. Most probably we'll be picking up with the GOS in already there. The group of secretaries, this is fast-tracking our projects. So we'll be very soon, all the 60 stations should be, RFQ should be issued by the end of this year. 50 by RLDAs also has been given target. So 110 stations, when this year ends, so works will be initiated on 110 stations.